Hello friends, Satyendra here, and in this video, let's design this sheet metal part by understanding some basic sheet metal design approach in Creo Parametric. So let's get started. So in my previous video, I explained about these four options in detail. I explained about the basic sheet metal design approach for sheet metal design in Creo Parametric. So if you have not seen those videos, then you must see those videos to understand the basic sheet metal design approach in Creo Parametric. The links are given below in the description area and right there on your screen. Just tap the link and watch the video. Now in this video, once again I will talk about these four options and I will talk about one new option which is called sheet metal join. Now this video will tell you why to use sheet metal join and how to use sheet metal join in Creo Parametric. So first, let's understand why to use sheet metal join. And to explain this, I have two similar parts with me. One is this part and another one is this part. So from shape and size point of view, both parts are exactly same, but from design approach, it differs. Now let's understand why to use sheet metal join. So sometime when you design a sheet metal part where you have a situation like this. This is your base wall and with this, this flange is attached. So since you have a straight edge, you can easily attach this kind of flange. Now I need one more flange over here, something like this. So this flange is attached with this end and this end. So when you have a flange which has to be attached this end and this end with a discontinued end, there is no such options available in Creo Parametric. So you don't have any option to create a flange which can be attached with two discontinued end. So when you have a straight end like this, you can easily attach flat or flange to add a secondary wall. But if you have a discontinued end, you cannot add a flange which is connected with these two end. In such cases, join helps a lot. So you just create a planar wall which is not linked with this. This is a separate wall. So you can see here, it is showing two pieces of sheet metal, distinct piece 1 and distinct piece 2. Now after creating this secondary wall, you can go with join and you can easily get the result you are looking for. Now this flange is connected with this end and this end, both the ends. So join is the very helpful option where you need to connect a flange with two discontinued end. Now the same result can be achieved by another way. So you can see the preview. Now you see, you are getting similar kind of result. You see? But to follow that approach, you must have the unbent dimension for this sheet metal part, which is slightly difficult in initial stage of the design. So now you understood why to use sheet metal join, and this is really nice option to achieve a complex shape sometime. So this was about why to create sheet metal join. Now the next thing is how to create sheet metal join. So that will come while designing this part. So let's understand the design approach for this particular sheet metal part. So if you see this sheet metal part carefully, you will find that this area can be manufactured by bending process. And this area also can be done by bending process. But if you see this portion carefully, you will find that it looks like a bending process. But this is not a bending process. This is a forming process. If it is a bending process, it should have some space to unbend. So since it is a forming process, you should not use any command which creates the bend. You should only go with forming tools. Now this entire part is created with bending commands except this particular feature. This is created by forming tools. So when you go for flat pattern, this formed portion just comes up and flatten with side surfaces. But if you go with second part, Here if you go for flat pattern, it doesn't flatten. You see here, if you go for preview, you get an error. So if I go for unbend, manual, and manually select the bend, I can get flatten for these two bends, except these bends. Now if I try to select these bends, just like this, and if I go for preview, it gives the error. So here for this part, I have used bending commands to create this feature, and that is why it is not getting flattened. If it is created by form tools, it will automatically flatten. So once you have created this feature with bending tools, you must have some opening to unbend it. For example, if I go for surface rip, and if I give some space to open this, now if I go for flat pattern, I can easily get the flat view. Now you see. So these are the two different design approach to design this sheet metal part. So while designing your sheet metal part, you must understand your manufacturing process and you must select your tools accordingly. Now let's understand this model tree, how this part is built. So this is the first wall, then this flange, then an unattached planar wall, then sheet metal join, then this is form tool, and then some cutouts like this, and at last the round. Now if you go for that part, the base wall is exactly same, then one flange is added, then another flange, this side, it creates a bend here, then this is mirrored, and then an extrude wall, then some cutouts, and at last the round. So this extrude wall creates a bend here, which doesn't allow you to flatten it. So instead of this extrude wall, if you go with form wall, you can easily get the flat pattern. But when you are going for form tool, then you must have a continuous wall here, which is difficult to get with flange or flat, because you cannot attach flat or flange with two discontinued end. So this was the complete idea to design this sheet metal part. Now let's start from the beginning. And to start this part, first I'll go with this base, which is nothing but this one. And for that, I'll go to planar. I'll select the datum plane, normal. I will draw a center line. I'll draw one line. This dimension is 2. This is 0.75. Now this entire sketch, I will mirror it. Now this height is 1.5. And this dimension is 3.5. Say OK. Now the next feature is this bottom flange. And for that I'll go to flat. I'll select this. I will drag it outside, and this also outside. I'll go to sketch, normal. Now this is 0.5. This is also 0.5. and this dimension I will delete. I will create one more dimension from here to this top end, and this is 1. And I'll say OK. Now this area I will clean it. I'll go to relief. I'll say rectangle. And this value I'll give 0.5. And I say OK. Now the next feature is this top flange, which is nothing but this one. And for that I will not go for flat or flange. I will go for planar. This surface. Now here I will draw the complete flange like this. So I'll go with line. I'll start from here. I'll just roughly draw like this. This is 0.2. This dimension, which is from this surface to this, this is 2. Now one line from here to here, this will go like this. Now this gap is 0.5 and say OK. Now you say OK. Now once you create this unattached planar wall, you get two distinct pieces here. Now how to create join? So go to editing, join, select this surface, press and hold control key and select this surface. But if you see here carefully, this portion of the material is getting removed. So go to option and select the second option. So this is for trimming option. So up to bend means after bend, whatever material is coming, it will be trimmed. But if you go for up to intersection line, then it will only trim up to intersection line. Now if you see this part, there is a clearance here, and that clearance you can get with relief. Go with any clearance. I will go with obround and I'll say OK. Now the next feature is this form feature, this one. And for that I'll go to form, sketch form. I select this surface, normal. Now I'll create one rectangle, something like this, one center line. I'll make it symmetry, this point and this point to this. Now this gap is 1, so make it 1. This you let it be 2.5. Now you say OK. Now flip it down. Add taper angle. Taper angle is given here, 50 degree. Now add rounds on all the bends. This value is 0.35. Now say OK. Now most of the features are created. Now you just need to create some cutouts onto this surface. Place the sketch. Place a center line. Mirror all these sketches. Apply the proper dimensions. Say OK. And say OK. Now the last thing is adding the rounds. Just go to round, start selecting the corners. Just like this, and create the rounds. So once it is done, if you go for flat pattern, you'll get a nice flat pattern like this. So this was about the sheet metal join and the proper design approach for form sheet metal part, and I hope this video will be helpful.